Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be dealing not with the lead editorial, rather I will be dealing with a very important topic related to economy. Now the topic is advance pricing agreement. Now this is a very important issue that has unfolded in the domain of economy. In order to understand this issue, first of all we need to understand about how economy works in realm of globalization, how globalization has impacted the functioning of economy. Now, in order to understand that, we need to take an example of any corporate sector or any manufacturing gadget that is produced by these corporate sectors or any MNCs. Now, when it comes to the assemblage of any product, it is getting complex day by day. Now, when it comes to the assemblage of any automobile in India, the assemblage has got complex with respect to the parts, with respect to the gadgets, sub-gadgets of what it is formed of. Now, what it means? It means that we need to import the sub-gadgetry in order to make one single gadget, in order to manufacture one gadget. Now, because the assemblage is getting very complex, it is also getting complex how to decide about the taxation procedure. Now, we have a very good example of Maruti Swift. Now, when it comes to Maruti Swift, though it is producing cars in India, but the car that it is producing in India, for that it is importing n number of gadgets from its parent company, that is Japan. Now, because it is importing a lot of gadgetry from there, lot of machinery from there in order to assemblage the entire Maruti Swift or any other car that the Maruti is manufacturing, it is paying some sort of amount to its companies from where it is getting those products, those machines, those sub gadgets imported. Now, because it is importing these, it has to pay the amount. But when it comes to the final profits of the Maruti company as such, these profits are decided on the basis of the amount it has to pay to the companies from which it had bought those subparts. Because those parts are not manufactured by Maruti as such, but are manufactured by a company that is related to Maruti. So in that case, when it comes to paying the final taxation, tax to the Indian government, the corporate tax, what it tends to do, it tends to actually put up a way higher price with respect to those importing gadgets, sub-gadgets, machinery or the tools that it is using to manufacture that Maruti Swift. So in that case, when it comes to the accounting, the way the accounting is done, it actually tends to undervalue the profit of Maruti in India. So in that case, the liability to pay the tax in India, it actually reduces. It is actually less in comparison to what it would have paid had it would have paid the right amount of the prices for the gadgets or for the machinery that it was importing from its parent country. So in this case, what is happening? Maruti company is trying to pay less taxes here and it is trying to pay more taxes in Japan. So that is actually causing a concern to the Indian exchequer, because our coffers are not getting filled despite them doing a good amount of business in India. So they are not paying the right amount of taxes to the Indian government. So in order to solve this thing, Indian government in past, it had come out with advance pricing agreement. So an agreement is reached between the tax officials in India, between the government of India and any corporate player or any MNC that is into manufacturing or that is also into the service sector. So with respect to that, an agreement is signed between two entities, the government and the seller. Like in this case, we have the Maruti. So the advance agreement, it is decided what will be the amount that it will be paying to the companies foreign for which it will be importing a particular gadgetry. Now those companies to which it is related. Now when it comes to Maruti, Maruti is not only functioning in India, but it is also functioning in Japan, and some of the products are being produced in Japan. So it cannot be the case that you will cause a GRV valve to be priced at a rate of 50,000 or 60,000, because it actually costs only 1,000 rupees. Just to undervalue your profits, you are doing this thing. So this advance pricing agreement is reached between the government and the companies, so that the governments can have more taxes from these corporate players. Now such mechanisms are devised in order to take care of how globalization has impacted the functioning of these corporate sector. Because presently the things are becoming very complex. You cannot be sure about how this carrier AC is getting manufactured, how LG product is getting manufactured, because in order to manufacture a washing machine, now all the sub gadgets that are used in the washing machine, they're not manufactured in India. They're manufactured in a company that is related to the parent company, but that company is placed somewhere else. It is placed at up in a country where the taxation laws are actually very laxed. So this is the reason that why India had already signed up this advance pricing agreements with the countries with which we are having double taxation avoidance treaty. But now we are also expanding this aspect so that we can have a better collection of the taxes. So this is very important topic for General Studies Mains Examination Paper 3, and this is important for 2018 Mains. So this was all for the day. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of this channel is Brain EIAS, and you can also contact me at 845-940-000 in case you have any sort of query with respect to this topic. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.